This isn't just about, you know, a movie, a comedy. It's about real life. It's about individuals who had a dream. And really, against all odds, you know, overcame, you know, the obstacles and, you know, persevered and did what they have to do to fulfill that dream.
Dudley Stokes is the man who made the dream come true. In 1987, George Fitch, an American bobsledder living in Jamaica, had the idea of setting up the island's first bobsleigh team. Stokes, then an officer in the air wing of the army, was selected to be the driver because of his athletic ability and hand-eye coordination. Fitch's inspiration had come from the similarity of bobsleigh to the island's homegrown sport of pushcart racing. With only 4 months to go before the Olympics, Dudley Stokes was busy making preparations with his brother Chris, Devon Harris and Michael White.
I am feeling very Olympic today.
By the final day, the team's previous runs had put them amongst the top 10 starters. From then on, nothing would go their way.
In the morning, first of all, I woke up with a fever. I had a temperature of over almost 102 degrees Fahrenheit. Then we got on the track, and I was walking up the track in the ice and slipped and broke my collarbone. So we got that fixed at the top with the magic spray. Then our coach left the country, went back home.
177, take 2 miles.
Against all the odds, Stokes and his team started their run. As in the movie, drama was just around the bend. On the Chrysler turn, the dream became a nightmare.
Number two, Devon Harris, he was wedged in so tightly, so my head was more or less trapped outside. I couldn't get it under, and the weight of his body had me basically pinned in that position. So it was just a matter of relaxing and taking it as it comes. It really wasn't, you know, it wasn't that bad, to be honest.
The experience didn't deter Stokes. 4 years later, the Jamaicans were back at Albertville, where in order to compete, they had to borrow a sled from the Germans. Finishing 24th out of 31 starters, their sponsorship plummeted and several of the team members retired. Facing possibly his hardest test ever, Stokes' ambition and determination wouldn't allow him to give in.
It's not just about bobsled, it's about life. Whatever you do, you get into doing, I think you should get into it to give it your best shot, to achieve your maximum potential. That is what I'm trying to do with Bob. I think that if I achieve my maximum potential in this sport, I will be, you know, at or very, very near the top. And I really wouldn't be satisfied with anything less.
Relying on his own savings and private contributions, Stokes was able to rebuild his team, mostly with army-trained ex-track and field athletes.
At the 1994 Olympic Winter Games in Lillehammer, Norway, things got off to a bad start when the two-man team of Dudley Stokes and Wayne Thomas was disqualified for having an overweight sled, caused from a change in runner blades just before the race. The news was devastating. It was to be the hour before dawn.
This competition has already been a nightmare for the United States. It will only get worse if Randy Will fails to finish ahead of the Jamaican sled, and that's a possibility heading into the final run. It was 6 years ago that Dudley Stokes and the Jamaicans burst onto the scene in Calgary. Back then, they were a likable sideshow, but some feared for their lives the way they were driving.
Yeah, he had no clue about driving the big four-man sleds, and this crash here, I thought, ended his career. To see him here, he's finally figured out how to drive a sled, Sean, and that's why he's where he is right now in the competition. He's got a clue about the sport, finally.
The first sled to take the final run of the competition, Jamaica won in 15th place heading into the final run when they were disqualified from the two-man last weekend for being overweight. The Jamaicans said they were concentrating their efforts on the four-man. They said they'd be a factor, that they'd finish in the top 15, and most people scoffed at them. Their best finish ever in the Olympics, 24th, 2 years ago. They are steadily improving.
Well, the start times is what's given them the chance to improve. There's a great start, 5:02, Sean. They're track and field athletes that are finally acclimating to cold weather. They've had a real rough time out in bobsledding, coming from a warm country like Jamaica, to figure out how to run and sprint in cold weather temperatures.
Of course, their story inspired the movie Cool Runnings, which was intended to be humorous and, in fact, was. But what has developed here from the American standpoint is not the least bit funny, as the Jamaicans have a chance to finish ahead of the only remaining American sled in the field. They're 23 hundredths of a second behind Randy Will coming into this final heat, but they picked up 38 hundredths on Will in the third heat.
Yeah, he's got good speed. He's got those DDG runners we're talking about on his sled. He's got a great piece of equipment underneath him. He's got a great time, 52.51. That's a great heat. 52.39 in one heat, 52.51 in the other. Dudley Stokes has finally figured out how to drive a sled.
He had the 10th fastest time the entire field in the third run, and he had a good run here.
This line here is a good medium-high line as he comes around 13. Watch the head snap. A little bit of rough transition. He drifts over to this wall. In the old days, he would have driven off that wall into the next wall and back and forth. He's finally figured out the less driving you do, the better success you have.
So he has put the pressure on Randy Will and the Americans. They need a good run to stay ahead of the Jamaicans and finish this Olympic competition ahead of Jamaica 1. Now the last run of Randy Will's career, driving USA 1 in 13th place. After three heats, they've been dropping back with every run. They were 8th after the first run, 10th after the second, now 13th. And they need a time of 52.74 to finish ahead of the Jamaicans. That would be a faster time than their first heat today.
He had a disastrous first heat today. Very average start time of 5:06. 5:06 again. The Jamaicans beat it by 400 at the start. I think the air was out of their bag in the first heat yesterday, Sean, when they didn't do better than the eighth place. They should have done a lot better than that with that fresh ice to work with.
Certainly Randy Will does not want to end his career, and he is retiring after the Olympics with the embarrassment of finishing behind the Jamaicans. It's a distinct possibility.
Well, he's losing time down the track here. And I think Randy just wants to get to the bottom, go home. His wife's expecting a baby in 10 days or so.
Through 13, hit the wall.
Not very good speed.
Remember, the time to beat to stay ahead of the Jamaicans, 52.74. He didn't do it.
100th of a second.
The Jamaicans will finish ahead of the only remaining United States sled in the four-man bobsled competition.
Nagano, deep in the winter of 1997. The temperature is -7 degrees Celsius. Not long ago, this team was considered the biggest joke in the Olympic Games. They were sprinters seeking sporting glory in an unfamiliar winter world. Their much heralded entry into Olympic history celebrated in a Disney movie. This is the Jamaican bobsleigh team. No longer the party boys of this grueling sport, this is their 10th year in bobsleigh and their 4th Olympic Games. Team leader and driver, Dudley Stokes, has spent endless hours at the Nagano track studying 15 curves. And unique to any bob track in the world, 2 uphill sections.
The track at Nagano is probably the most exciting track in bobsleigh. There is no real big problem with crashing or anyone getting hurt there, but there is a very real problem with going fast in Nagano. It's very technical. It's a track with a lot of speed. Corners come at you very quickly, and that is exciting.
10 years ago, Dudley was one of the founders of the Jamaican bobsleigh team. Now, at 35, Nagano will be his swan song.
Bobsled requires that I'm away for about 5 months in the year. About 3 of those months are continuous, and it's difficult on family life. So I will have to call it quits after Nagano.
Yes, good morning, Mr. Clark.
Without the considerable input of Dudley Stokes and his brother Chris, the Jamaican dream may well die. The 1998 Winter Olympic Games could mark the last appearance of the Jamaican bobsleigh team.
We are not afraid, although we know there's much to fear. We were moving mountains long before we knew we could.
Now, this is the law of the jungle, as old and as true as the sky. And the wolf that shall keep it may prosper, but the wolf that shall break it must die. As the creeper that girdles the tree trunk, the law runneth forward and back. For the strength of the pack is the wolf, and the strength of the wolf is the pack.
Who knows what miracles you can achieve when you believe somehow you will when you believe.
While there are some who have gone further than you have gone, none has come as far as you have come.
When you believe.